Liminal is a design-based and research-oriented practice that supports small towns in Italy in re-envisioning a more just, inclusive, and sustainable future.
We imagined a future for the Italian territory where there could be a decentralized distribution of economic opportunity, of well-being, and in very simple terms, a future that people could get excited about.
This whole workshop is actually an experiment. An experiment in understanding how we can look at these issues, how we can intervene and help, right? Where is our contribution needed? Where is it not? And it is also an experiment in saying, okay, what if we actually come, stay in a town with 20 students, what happens then?
My name is Ipshita Karmakar. I'm an architect from India, and I'm doing my Master's of City Planning here at MIT DASP.
I'm Lexi. I'm a junior at MIT. I'm majoring in mathematics, and I'm minoring in finance.
Hi, my name is Adriana. I am an MArch student at MIT, and it is my second going into my third year.
My name is Ava. I'm from Massachusetts, and I just finished my Master's in Mechanical Engineering at MIT.
My name is Lauren Gideons. I'm an architect within the Masters of Architecture program at MIT.
I'm Ginevra D'Agostino. I've recently graduated from MIT. And at MIT, I was able to co-found with Carmelo Ignacola and Nicolas Delgado Alcea an organization called Liminal.
So what motivated me to come here the most was actually the work that Liminal was doing that I knew from MIT, and beginning to understand how to implement new forms of ecotourism in neighborhoods that are trying to become more sustainable and at the same time have been stuck in the past.
Exactly, I imagined it to be a picturesque, postcard-like Italian town, and it is. Now that I'm living here, I'm more in touch with the reality of the problem. Like, there are several infrastructural and livelihood problems that we have, as we have in any other country, in any other world. And I think that also exists here in rural Italy. So I think some of my preconceived notions were broken. But it still remains a picturesque, beautiful, postcard-like Italian town. So.
We found that there was an exhaustion with a model where maybe two or three cities really contained all of the opportunity for people trying to construct a life for themselves. And we saw that there was a real desire to reinvent what life could look like in medium and small-sized cities as well as towns. And so this led us to discover all of the kinds of opportunities that some of the inner areas of Italy and the Italy of small municipalities hold. We were able to get exposure to not only many of the challenges that are faced by some of these small communities, but also some of the potentials that lie within them.
The train ride on the second day has really colored my experience so far, has had a lasting effect. Something about moving through the landscape, not in a car, with a group of people, with the windows open, sort of blurring that line between being a sightseer or someone looking at the landscape and being in the landscape. Very different type of interaction.
My background is in architecture, and I've been working in the discipline for many years now. And a question that I've been bringing forward throughout since my kind of teenager years was, how do you deal with these kind of ruined towns? And their like slow abandonment often leads to like physical ruination of these houses to an extent that is no longer even possible to rehab them, restore them. And so to what extent can we provide a system of physical support through on these smaller structures in order for them to be kind of preserved over time and still be standing for the opportunity or a hopeful day when they could be re-inhabited over time.
Building the Edge workshop is the first pilot project that Liminal is currently advancing in Abruzzo region. We strongly support this pilot project and we believe it could have a long-term impact on the communities and people we're interacting with in these days. Having like students and faculty members from top universities in the world, such as people coming all the way from Boston to investigate how these shrinking cities can survive and what are the sort of development trajectories for these communities, it's actually a statement to our passion and desire to contribute to the improvement of these territories. Throughout this workshop, MIT students have been engaging in conversation, interviews, and discussion with people from many different backgrounds. They've been exposed to like people studying like wildlife, people studying like agricultural production in the Abruzzo area around Sulmona, and people who are mostly working on cultural heritage preservation. By providing students with the opportunity to engage with different stakeholders, we believe that they could come up with a different range of outputs, mostly visual, that could be used by mayors and local community members to raise awareness and also promote new strategic planning that can have the support of European funding, national funding, and finally get on the ground as a tangible implementation.
We are not even 1 year old and we managed to actually create this partnership with these entities that can have an impact on the territory. So it's not about extracting resources necessarily, but it's actually about enriching the territories themselves. Throughout this year, we have participated to several grants. Also, it's along with South Working. We have collaborated with them in writing and helping through this Bando del Ministero della Cultura, Minister of Culture grant. And so now we're waiting to hear from a lot of these proposals that we made with different regions in Italy. The towns in the region of Abruzzo, the towns in the region of Lazio, towns in Sicily. So we are kind of trying to be active in different areas of Italy, but right now Liminal Lab is really what we're hoping to put most of our energies in, mainly in creating more partnerships with more stakeholders that could have an interest in these areas. And other research entities, both Italian universities and American universities. So really expanding our possibility to create synergies between different worlds that if working together, they can make, I think, something really meaningful.
I'm taking home from this experience an in-depth understanding of the attention to detail and care that is required to execute this kind of project, but also a willingness from the people to really move these things forward at a much faster rate if given the opportunity. I think I'm learning a lot. In America, there seems to be a faster way of moving. And I'm learning a lot architecturally and as a way of designing by looking at time and the investment of time at a different scale that is present here.
I had had all these ideas about what we might be trying to do, but I had to put those aside to listen to others, and I think that was a really valuable thing to have to learn for myself, and I'll be able to take that. And that's not always something you get in a class at MIT. In classroom setting, it's someone giving ideas to you, and you might question them, but you are usually trying to, just given the fast-paced environment of a class, get to a conclusion quickly. But here, that doesn't really benefit. Being a part of this program and being able to engage with so many different people from so many different experiences and education levels and speaking different languages makes me each day wake up and challenge my assumptions and open my mind a little bit more. And that's something that I think is valuable for anyone.
MISTI gives you an opportunity to do is to actually, it allows you to travel. As someone who didn't have the financial security to travel as much before this, I feel like MISTI gave me an opportunity to do that, to actually go to different places and engage with different communities. So that is definitely something that I recommend. For students, I think there is a lot of value to actually being at a place and learning about it and studying it and learning from communities rather than doing it from a laptop somewhere else. So I think this is a good opportunity for every student or professional or practitioner who wants to do this.
I think that I will take home from this experience a better understanding of how to structure a project where you're bridging different municipalities, bridging different interests, a more measured way of kind of filtering or critically interpreting what stakeholders are saying. I think that Ginevra and Nicholas have set up a really beautiful kind of movement through different opinions so that it's left to us to parse how those perspectives and stakes or motivations kind of can interact. And I think seeing the architect as that position, as the sort of a critical lens and a moderator between different special interest groups is powerful. And I might try and work a bit more like that in my own practice.
I would 110% recommend this program. I think it's been amazing. I've gotten to learn so much about a variety of different fields, architecture, engineering, computer science, mathematics, finance, but I've also been able to apply these skills into a real world problem. I think that MIT has so many different international experiences. I think that this one is unique in that it is a very quick immersion into the culture. We are fully submerged into this region of Italy, and I think that there are many different projects that we are pursuing. So I 110% recommend all MIT students to have an experience like this. And if you're not an MIT student, then I recommend that you try to figure out a way that you can get involved abroad as well.